Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Kashish Mendiratta. We have started the C++ STL series and we have made two videos on it. First video was on C++ templates to show you that why we need a template library, why it's not just a library of arrays, why it's not library of just set or anything else, why it's a template library. Our second video was of the custom vector, in which I have showed you that how the code is there inside the C++ STL. That means how a container is made in C++ STL, so that you can better understand the containers and other C++ STL functions. So in this video, I will be telling you what are the contents of C++ STL and how we are going to study in our upcoming lessons. So basically, C++ STL is divided into three parts. First part is the containers. So containers are nothing just like means a data structure to hold our data, means that can be in the form of a tree, that can be in the form of an array. So containers can be of any, just like we can implement the array as a container, we can implement vector, which is a dynamic array. We will discuss all of the things in our upcoming lectures. We can implement the set using the tree, we can implement the multi-map. These all are the containers. Means containers provides an interface of using the data structures and in an effective way. So after the containers, etc. So after the containers, there are iterators. So iterators means we can iterate over the containers to get some specific values. So for example, we are having a set and we want to iterate over the set. So we need a iterator to iterate over the set. For example, if the set has values 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 4, 5, 6. So iterator will help to iterate over the different elements of this set. We will be discussing about the various iterators in each of the above data structures, each of the above containers. So iterators, for example, if there is a data structure, iterator will be like data structure name dot begin. So similarly, data structure name dot end. And it can be, if we want to iterate from the last element to the first element, we can be use rbegin. So these all are the iterators, and we can simply increase the iterator using the ++ operator as we can increment the numbers. After the iterators, the third thing is algorithms. So algorithms are used to make our lives easy. Means if we are having a container and we want to apply some algorithms, so basic algorithms are implemented in the C++ STL library. We can directly use that and reduce our coding time and space also. So algorithms, there are various algorithms like binary search. We can sort the elements and we can transform the elements, and what else we can do? We can apply many other things. We can insert is a member function. So all the things we can apply on the algorithms, we can find the permutations. So these all are the three parts of the C++ STL, and we will be covering all these things. And in the container also, we will be covering its four types. First one is the sequential containers. That means we are working on a linear data structures. And that can be array, that can be a vector, that can be a DQ. If you don't know any one of that, we will be covering all that. After that, after the sequential, we have container adapters. So in the container adapters, these all are the sequential containers, but the difference is that they have little restrictions, and you can say they have different, means you can use them in a certain way only. For example, if there is a stack is just like an array, but it has some restrictions that we can get the element from the top only, we can push the element on the top only. So similarly, queue and priority queue. So these all are the container adapters. After that, we have associative containers. So these are the containers which work on the sorted data. So we have set in that, we have map in that. Set is used to just have a list of all the elements which occur just once, and in this we can get the elements in a sorted way. Set, we have map, we have multi-map. Similarly, we have multi-set also. After the associative containers, we have unordered associative containers. So, these work on the unsorted data, and these all types occur but with unordered. So, if there is a set in associative containers, there is unordered set in unordered associative containers, similarly unordered map, unordered multi-map, and unordered multi-set. So, these all are the contents of the C++ STL, and we will be covering all from the upcoming videos. We will be starting from the containers, and starting from the containers and iterators, because iterators depend upon containers to be used. So, we will be covering these two topics at once, and after that we will be covering the important algorithms in C++ STL. Okay, so meet you in the next video.